tongue and hold my breath. Scared to rock the boat and make a mess. So I said quietly, agreed politely. I guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me past the breaking point. I stood for nothing, so I fell for everything. You held me down, but I got up. Already pushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound. Like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, cause I've had enough.
Aren't you tired? It's almost the end of the year and you kept on just putting it off and I'll do it tomorrow and there's this holiday and there's this party and I'll do it later and you haven't done anything. Do I have this down pack? No, I don't. But I do know that I need to get better. Let me share a testimony, something that happened to me. I don't like long videos, but I think that you really need to take the time to really listen to this. Not because it's me, but for the information, for the encouragement, for the motivation that you've been seeking. I got to the point that many times, and you can ask my children, I couldn't get out of bed. I was 253 and I just couldn't get out just to go to the bathroom. And I would have to literally roll myself to the corner of the bed and inching because of the pain, sit on this chair, on this here, this computer chair, and sit there and then with a cane, push myself up, crying with tears to go to the bathroom. Something simple that you take for granted every day. I couldn't do it. Did that happen to me every day? No. There were times, I guess, I would turn a certain way and I would hurt my back and my spinal cord. I mean, it was bad. I did get to that point. It was horrible. And just the fact of trying to walk to the mailbox and feeling myself tired, it was bad. I encourage you, don't wait till that happens to you. Don't wait till what happened to me. I got two small strokes and I had to be in medicine for almost a year, almost 2 years I was on Coumadin. Don't let that happen to you. I'm still working on me. There are days, yes, I do eat wrong, and there are days that I don't exercise, and then I feel it. But I know that I have to motivate myself, and I know that I have to do this. And I encourage you, don't wait till it's too late. And your body, you know, you keep on putting it off and saying, I'll do it later, or maybe next week, maybe next week, maybe won't come. And I'm not trying to scare you. It's not a scare tactic. It's reality. Next week, you might, you know, hurt your back or do something where you can't move. And then it's harder because you already have those pounds on you. So I encourage you each and every day, just 10 minutes and then 20 and then 30, and you will see it get better. Don't tell me you don't have time. I'm tired of those excuses. You have to make time for you. Don't tell me that you have this big schedule. You have to feed the kids and your husband and blah, blah, blah. You have to do you first. If you have to wake up an hour earlier, do it. Half an hour early, do it. It's for you. You need to work on yourself. This is not about vanity. This is about your health. And you need to do it for you, for your family,